Heroes, Tapu Lele, and Cresselia. So Connor is actually not in the Masters division. He is a senior, but he is currently doing very well for himself at this tournament, playing way above his age range. So it's always awesome to see the kind of different tactics and different play styles that we see from different age divisions. So I think it's going to be a really interesting match to see how these two age divisions pair off against each other. So one common thing that I think we see from both of these teams is they both have that Lele and that Metagross. So Lele Metagross has been a super common core for most of this year, and I think it's going to be not as important in this match as others, though for Connor he does have to watch out because his Como is unfortunately very weak to both the Metagross and that Lele without getting its speed boost and outspeeding it afterwards. Another Mon that we see from both ends is that Naganadel. Naganadel being one of those Pokemon where it has very small usage here and there, not being the strongest of all the Pokemon around, but it does have the ability to do some pretty cool things. It does get Sludge Bomb with Stab, Draco Meteor, and of course you can't undervalue Tailwind. Alright, as it looks like we're going to be heading into the match here. For Sean, I think one of his best ways of winning right now will be trying to eliminate Connor's Komo-o, potentially, either with his Metagross or his Lele, but I think we will have to see Connor try to counter that strategy, but let's hop into it. Another interesting thing we see here on Connor's team is that Cresselia. Cresselia being one of those Mons that, like, wasn't very popular at the beginning of this year, but has really picked up usage again after being super prevalent in almost every year of VGC since it's been introduced. It has changed a little bit, not looking like it's going to be the common set that we see with it being more bulky boy and then trying to set up Trick Room for its supporting allies. But I think we're going to see something a little bit different. But as we hop into this match of Priority or Sean Bannon on the left and Connor on the right. Alright, and it looks like Connor is sending that challenge. As we see Connor lead off with the Tapu Lele and that Naganadel and Metagross and Aegislash for Sean Bannon. Alright, from the initial start, I think if I was Connor, I would be in a very happy spot with this lead. Naganadel does have access to some pretty powerful fire moves, able to pick up the knockout on some Metagrosses if it is potentially running that Fire Z move, which has I've seen a couple times. But that's not as likely. So what I think we might see here is we might see a Tailwind come out from that Naganadel if it is carrying it, and that Lele potentially protecting, scared of that Z-move from that Aegislash. Or Metagross also, because Metagross does really like to hurt that Lele. Unfortunately, if Sean is carrying Bullet Punch, he is not going to be able to break that Sash on that Naganadel, but we do see the Metagross go for that pretty obvious Mega Evolution. Not worried about preserving his clear body. As we see the Lele actually go for Shadow Ball, moving before any other Pokemon, indicating that is most likely Scarfed, as he does get that special defense drop. Ice Punch coming out into that Naganadel, doing a good amount of damage, knocking it down to its Sash. As we see Naganadel go for a Tailwind here, ensuring that everything on his team is faster. And we see that stance change from Aegislash going for a straight up Shadow Ball into that Naganadel. If I'm Connor right now, I'd be pretty satisfied with how this first turn went. So now he has the ability to go into any Mon that he wants. Both of Sean's Pokemon are in fact weak to that Shadow Ball that Lele locked itself into. So even though he might have been down on one Pokemon, I still think he is up in advantage. So let's see, he goes out to that Komo-o. Komo-o is in a pretty good position right now to just go straight off for its Z-move, then getting those plus one stats. The only thing he might have to worry about is it might not knock out that Metagross if Sean does go for the wide guard, though. And Lele right now is pretty free just to Shadow Ball whatever he thinks is the bigger issue as we see Sean just go for that King Shield. Just trying to avoid some of that damage, maybe reduce the damage of Komo Z move as we see Shadow Ball just pick up the KO on that Metagross. And Komo actually just going straight for the Flamethrower. No boost yet. Potentially scared of that Aegislash's Z move, which we did see earlier in the day, or if he's just scared of a regular Shadow Ball. Alright, so right now Sean is not in a very good position. He is definitely playing from behind in this match. I think it's going to be very difficult for Sean to get back in this match with two turns of Tailwind left, I believe. Sean is going to have to do some clever play to get back into it. He doesn't have any way of really stopping that Komo OZ move besides just flat out knocking it out with his own Lele or his Aegislash if he is able to get off enough damage with that Z move or a Shadow Ball if it is enough. And Connor's Lele is a very strong position right now. It's not going to be able to pick up the KO onto that Aegislash, but it will do a good amount of damage. So I hope we see that this Aegislash is able to potentially do some of the things, as it looks like we might have a little bit of inner signal issues here. But let's hope that isn't the case. Yeah, as the timer is not counting down. Oh, is it counting? It is not. Okay. So, unfortunately, it looks like we might have a game freeze here or a disconnect, but judges are attempting to reconnect us here. Alright, but so right now, honestly, this little bit of extra time to think might be a boon to Sean right now, because he's not in a great position, and having those extra time above the 45 seconds might be helpful. Alright, as it looks like we actually do have a game freeze here. So I think we're going to, after they get the chart to decide who is the winner from this game, we are going to grab, they're going to go grab that chart on what to do, and then we will see. Right now, just based on Pokemon and percentage left, I actually believe they are at a perfect tie. So I think, if I'm not mistaken on how it goes down, I believe it goes down to HP total, total percentage, or not HP total percentage, HP total, but I don't quite remember how game freezes go at this point in the match. Oh, thank you. Alright, so right now it is 3-3, so it is a tie, actually. Thank you. So, moving forward, so we're just going to hop into Game 2 as soon as everyone gets booted back up here. So that's... So honestly, that tie is not the most ideal situation for Connor. But, I mean, for Sean, that actually was a very nice and lucky game freeze, because now he doesn't have to deal with that loss, he just ends it with a tie. So that is an unfortunate way for this round to start, but, I mean, it is Pokemon, there are mistakes, there are some unfortunate things that happen, but I think we can definitely see this continue, and I think will be exciting to see how players adjust to having a tie in the games. So ties are one of those things that we don't often see unless it is a game freeze. I've seen one perfect tie in my entire time of playing, and that was with a Chansey mirror back in the day. But I think right now we're probably just going to see some hopefully getting back to this game here, and hopefully Sean has figured out what he wants to do, and hopefully Connor has figured out what he wants to do again. Because Connor was really very much in the lead during that game. So Connor, if I was Connor, even though it ended in a tie, I definitely was happy with how he played that game. And looking at Sean, Sean definitely has some very big ways to improve himself, improve for next time. Or for this time, rather, even. Alright, so as we see their teams again of Metagross, Tapu Lele, Aegislash, Blaziken, Snorlax, and Naganadel for Sean, and for Connor, we see the Naganadel, Landorus, Therian, Komo, Metagross, Tapu Lele, and Cresselia. So this is going to be an exciting match, because you don't often see going into a game 2 with no one actually winning a game. So this is going to be a very interesting match. So if I was Sean, one thing that I might want to consider changing is that that Tapu Lele, he now has the information that it is scarfed and that it does outspeed his Metagross, most likely his Lele. I don't believe we saw what his item was yet. His Aegislash, I think it pretty much outspeeds the entirety of his team, which is going to be a very rough spot. I think Naganadel has a small chance to outspeed if it's modest Lele, but I don't quite remember my speed calcs on that. But as we see, we're hopping into the game. Game 2 after that tie there from Double Game Freeze. Or Double Game Freeze, I believe? Or Double Game Freeze. Alright, as we see Connor lead off with the Tapu Lele and a Ganadel, and we see Sean with the Aegislash Metagross. Alright, so we're seeing the same leads, I believe, from the last game. So, if I was Sean, I might have to figure out, do I need this Lele gone? Because if the Lele is sticking around and is able to just fire off those Shadow Balls, three things on Sean's team are in fact weak to that Shadow Ball doing tons of damage. If I am Connor, I don't know if I would play it perfectly the same as I did last time, because now Sean is going to be expecting that. And without the one game buffer as he was in the lead before, but as we just do see, he does go for that Shadow Ball into that Metagross again, doing a good amount of damage, definitely going to be a two-hit KO. The Iron Head going into that Naganadel, attempting to go for the flinch most likely, as he does manage to get off that Tailwind. As we see the Aegislash go ahead and change its stance, and I think we're probably going to see a physical its attack into Lele. Alright, so Lele does go down there, but for that trade, Connor is able to get up that Tailwind, and he still has his Naganadel around from last time. So I honestly think if I was Connor, I think I'd be more happy with how it happened last time, because Naganadel is not as strong against Sean's team as we saw that Lele was. But he does just go out to that Como. Como is one of those mons where very recently, it's just been super popular, taking tournament after tournament and just showing up at all of them. I've heard stories of players that said at some of the recent tournaments they've been to, it was just been 5 or 6 rounds of playing Como every match. So I definitely think it's one of the strongest mons in the format right now. But right now, I think the Naganadel is honestly just kind of in the way. Naganadel not being the strongest mod against this team, it will be able to not finish off that Metagross if it does have the player move, but we just see that Metagross going for the Protect. Aegislash going ahead and just changing its stance back to that Shield form, trying to avoid some of that big damage. Alright, and I think we are just going to see that Flamethrower come off into that Metagross, as we see the Como go for the C move, boosting all of its stats. Too much damage as it is resistant and even through Protect, as Como does get all of those boosts going. If I'm Sean, I'm in a very bad position right now. Como has the boost. My Metagross, one of the things that could really handle it, is almost KO'd. At last game, we saw that Como has Flamethrower. Sean is not in a very ideal situation. I think we could see the Naganadel just go straight for the Flamethrower, and that Flamethrower onto that Aegislash, or maybe even just pick up the KO onto that Metagross, and then we could see the Como just go for a Flamethrower onto that Aegislash, or maybe Protect. I think Protecting here might be an interesting play to ensure that the Flamethrower next turn can KO it from the Como if he does attack into it with that Naganadel. As we see the Flamethrower coming out from the Como onto the Aegislash, doing a good amount of damage. And then we see that Naganadel going for the Flamethrower as well into the Metagross, knocking out that Metagross, bringing this game a little bit closer into Connor's favor. Naganadel getting that special attack beast boost, which is some pretty good information for Sean to have now. As Aegislash just goes for the Shadow Ball into that Naganadel, picking up that KO. So right now, if I'm Sean, I'm very scared of that Como. Unfortunately for him, though, I don't know if there's going to be too much he can do. If he switches back to if he King Shields once again, he will avoid damage for the turn, but as we saw, That flamethrower does do enough damage to pick up the KO from this range, even through the shield form's massive defenses. As we see Connor go out to the meta Gross, and we see Sean's own Tabu Lele. Right now, Sean is not in the greatest of positions. Sean unfortunately needs to be able to protect and outspeed that Metagross and also that Komo-o, and unless he's somehow scarfed and also protect, I don't think we're going to be able to see that. And we see that Tabu Lele switch on out, and it's going into Snorlax, as we see Metagross just go for the Mega Evolution to Metagrossite. Right now, if I'm Connor, I'm in a very good position. I don't think Sean really has too much of a way out of this game, but Sean is a very experienced player, as we see him going for that King Shield. Once again, just changing back, trying to survive another turn, as Komo does go for that Flamethrower, and Iron Head going into that Snorlax. As that opposing team's Tailwind does peter out, but everything on Connor's side of the field is already faster. So it's going to be a very rough game for Sean here, if it's even possible at all. Unfortunately for Sean, I don't know how much he's going to be able to do at this point. Another Flamethrower will pick up the KO onto his Aegislash. It will pick up the KO, I believe, a Zen Headbutt from that Metagross if it is carrying it. I know they've been dropping it recently. We'll pick up the KO. It'll be pretty close. And then I'm not sure how Sean's going to pull this game back. With the Lele in the back, he's not going to be able to really deal with both of these moves at the same time, as Aegislash does switch out for that Tabu Lele. As we saw Connor there getting a little excited, so I think we saw a prediction here with the Focus Blast actually going off into that Snorlax, as it is able to pick up that KO. Focus Blast isn't a move we see too often because of its pretty poor accuracy, but we do see how much it's paying off as we see the Lele just go down to that Iron Head. The weirdness has disappeared from the field, and I believe that Connor will take this game too. Alright, Aegislash. Alright, it looks like we're going to see Sean actually hit the forfeit button, trying to maybe preserve some information, or just hop into the next game as fast as possible. Alright, if I'm Connor, I am very happy with how that game went. He was in control almost the entirety of that match. If I'm Sean, though, I think Sean does have the tools that he needs for this matchup to be able to pull it back. Something that I think we might be able to see from Sean is that if Mega Metagross is able to get off an attack onto that Komo-o, I think Connor's team will have a bit of trouble getting going again. Or if we do see that Lele being able to lead off and pick up that KO. But it's going to be a very rough matchup for Sean. But he definitely does have some of the tools that he needs to do it. And with clever play, I'm sure we can see it. Alright. Once again, we see Sean with that Metagross, Tapu Lele, Aegislash, Blaziken, Snorlax, and Naganadel, and Connor once again with the Naganadel, Landorus, Komo-o, Metagross, Tapu Lele, and Cresselia. If I'm Connor, though, I honestly don't think I'm going to change up pretty much anything about my strategy from last time. Alright, as we hop into this game 3 here, it's definitely going to be a rough one for Sean if he's able to back. As we actually see our competitors jamming out a little bit to the music over there. It's always nice, because not too many people use their music, but as we see Connor lead off with that Tapu Lele Naganadel, and we see Sean with the Aegislash and his own Naganadel. Naganadel often carries Assassin, as we saw earlier with Connor's. So right now, if I'm Sean, I'm pretty happy with how this went, actually. He might know if his Shadow Ball will be able to pick up the Lele without using a Z-move, potentially, or if he even just wants to go straight for the Tailwind and then maybe worry about that Tapu Lele a little bit later if he thinks that is necessary. But we see Lele just go for the Shadow Ball into that Naganadel, breaking its potential Sash, doing a good bit of damage along the way. We see Sean to go for his own tailwind with his Naganadel, revealing that he is most likely faster than the other one, or it could have been his speed tie. Alright, Aegislash does go for that, stance change as he Shadow Balls into that Lele, doing a good amount of damage and actually able to pick up the KO straight out. If I'm Sean, I'm a little bit more happy with my positioning right now than I was in the last game. Lele, without the ability to use Shadow Ball, won't be doing as much damage as he was taking last time, as we do see that combo, actually. If Naganadel is carrying that Draco Meteor, I think Sean is in a pretty okay place, but Draco Meteor does often require another move slot that Naganadel sometimes just doesn't have. It needs Flamethrower, Tailwind, and often Sludge Bomb, and then Protect is always nice to have, so we might actually see Sean not have that Dragon move that he needs to pick up the KO on that Como. Or if we do just see a double up into it, that should also pick up the KO as well. Alright, as we see, Aegislash actually just go ahead and change its form back into its shield form, trying to avoid some of that damage. And maybe trying to get it so he can pick up the KO next turn after it's already changed forms. After Komos has already popped its Z-move. As we see Sludge Bomb come out from both Naganadels. Alright, as we do see that Komo just once again go for its Z-move. And we see that Naganadel does obviously go down. It was at just a sliver of HP as Komo gets all of its boosts once again. Alright, so now I think if I'm Sean, oh, it's going to be a rough one for Sean to pull out of this. As we did see earlier, that Naganadel does have Flamethrower, and also the Komo does have Flamethrower as well. So I think it's going to be rough for him to pull out of this, because two Flamethrowers should pick up the KO. But we actually see Sean going out to that Tapu Lele. Alright, so let's see what goes on here. So Aegislash is in a pretty good position right now. It will take a lot of damage from both of those Flamethrowers, I believe picking up the KO along the way. But if it is able to hold on to it, or if Sean is able to get that double protect or call what Connor is going to do correctly, he could get a good amount of damage off with his Lele, or maybe even pick up the KO onto that very, very scary Komo. As we just see the Komo go for the Flamethrower into the Aegislash, doing a good amount of damage. Moonblast comes out into the Naganadel, actually, picking up the KO there, revealing that Sean is most likely Scarfed, or not even most likely, I believe it is confirmed Scarfed at this point. And then we see the Ghost DMZ finally coming out from the Aegislash, definitely going into that Komo-O slot. Sean is probably hoping that this is just going to do just enough damage to pick up the KO, but Komo can be pretty defensively bulky, especially defensively bulky, as we do see it engulfed in the shadows of the Z-move, doing a good amount of damage, but not quite enough to pick up the KO. I don't even believe that it is within range for a Shadow Sneak, even if there wasn't Psychic Terrain up. But now with Sean unfortunately being in a not great spot for himself, that Metagross will be able to pick up the KO on the Lele. Komo might be able to just be able to protect, and then I just don't know if Sean's going to be able to pull it off, but he does have another Mon in the back, which we have not seen yet. Alright, as we do see Metagross go for that Mega Evolution, Komo does actually just go for that Protect. Pretty safe play on here. As we see Tapu Lele go for the Moonblast, Aegislash staying in its regular form, Iron Head coming off, picking up that KO on Tapu Lele. As we see, most likely that Shadow Ball going into that Metagross. Oh, and it is able to just survive, unfortunately for Sean. Sean is now not in a great position. If I was Sean, I might have tried to play a little bit more risky, switching out my Lele, because I know that it is pretty much the linchpin of my match at that point. Alright, so we're going to see Metagross come out. Metagross is at full HP, and it is a potential speed tie against that against Connor's Metagross. And if I'm Connor, honestly, I think I can just Flamethrower that Metagross and then, or maybe even Flamethrower the Aegislash, just guaranteeing that it's not going to be sticking around, or it attacks into a King Shield, and then Metagross, potentially running Stomping Tantrum, which will be able to most likely two-hit KO that Metagross. Actually revealing Shaun not Mega Evolving for some reason, as we soon see that Flamethrower go into it, and Stomping Tantrum going into the Aegislash, which should be able to pick up the KO. Alright, and I think at this point, without too much of a chance, I don't think Sean's gonna be able to pull this out. I believe Stomping Tantrum has a 5% chance to miss. Or no, Stomping Tantrum's 100%. So I don't really think there's going to be too much of a way for Sean to pull this game back. If Sean predicted maybe last turn of the double up into, or not double up into, the spread of his attacks properly, he could have been able to pull this back. If he knocked out the Como and then maybe got a little bit lucky with Speed Ties against that Metagross. But at this point, I just think we're going to see Como go for a Flamethrower. Stomping Tantrum coming out. Just an Iron Head coming out. As we see the Metagross fall, and we see Connor win this game. Great match from both of the opponents. Connor playing that game very well, knowing exactly what he had to do every game just to pull off that victory. Connor is doing very well. I believe he is 3-0 at this point. And all right, and we're gonna go ahead and go to a wait screen. And I'll be right back.